Hello, I'm happy to present to you one of the key technologies that led ChoRobot to win the KUKA Innovation Award 2021. And the title is Learning Robots Dual Arm Coordination in the Manipulation of Elastic Elements from Intuitive Human Demonstrations. I am Christian Vergara, and we are members from the robotic research team from KU Leuven and also members from Flanders MEC. So our motivation is to automate tasks that involve elastic elements. So for example, the installation of O-rings. We can see that in this kind of tasks that it is required the coordination of two hands, and also it's important to take into account the interaction forces between the elastic element, the hands, and also the piston. Several research groups have proposed already different approaches to perform this kind of task. So, for example, the laboratory LASA from EPFL proposed a benchmark to start to evaluate different approaches using, for example, this kind of task that is the installation of rubber band in this kind of bracket. In the context of installation of O-ring, the laboratory of Osaka, Japan proposed to use an approach in which motions of a bimanual manipulator are computed using CHOMP, while decreasing the internal forces of the O-ring during the motions. So instead of using grippers as in the previous approaches, we propose to use an application-specific component. We can see, for example, in the configuration of two arms of humans and also similar approaches using, for example, the shadow hand, that there are like larger number of degrees of freedom that are involved that makes more complex the control of all the motions for performing this kind of tasks. Even if we start to approach with more simple grippers, such as, for example, two-finger gripper, there are already grasping uncertainties associated, like involved in the manipulation. And also, depending on the configuration of the fingers, there might be also unstable grasping. So then we propose to use 3D printing to develop, for example, this kind of hooks that make more robust and more reliable the handling of the O-ring for installing by, for example, inserting this kind of hooks in the groove of the piston during the installation. To commission the motion of the robots, we use our method, our learning from demonstration method that was presented in August 2020. That is called trajectory parameterized probabilistic principal component analysis, in which an operator performs five demonstrations towards taking into account different relative positions between the support and also the piston mockup, showing with these controls that are equipped with pulse trackers and force torque sensors the required coordination of the motion of the arms, also the forces and the torques that are involved during the execution of the task. Then our method can generalize correlations and also variability between the signals. So then our reactive controller Etacell commissioned the motion of the robot. To this end, for example, we first get the position using an off-the-shelf system. In this case, we use a Pickett system. Then we generate like position trajectories with respect to this obtained position from the camera, and the correlation then generates all the signals of forces, orientation, moments, and the speed of advancement. Then for the evolution, let's consider first an instance that is dependent on how much this instance have evolved from the beginning, so the degree of advancement. And to commission the evolution of this instance, we need to take into a look in the speed of advancement and constrain the time derivative of this degree of advancement to follow this speed of advancement profile. Then we can generate time invariant evolution. For the robot motion, we constrained a task frame located in the tip of the hook to follow the generated positions and also the orientations. And we can also generate compliance motion taking into account the generated signals and the measured signals. So then the difference will generate translation, and the difference between the generated torques and the measured torques generate rotation around the task frame. So during the execution, Your robot first takes a picture in which it locates the position of the piston and also the position of the support where there is the O-ring. It goes to initial configuration similar to the one shown during the demonstration, generates the corresponding motions and follows these motions to grasp the O-ring. Look that the robot is also avoiding collisions, for example, with the piston. Once it grasps the O-ring, then it goes to perform the corresponding motions to, for example, extend it, insert it in the piston, insert it in the groove, and then to get into contact, like stable contacts with the piston, and follow the groove to finalize the installation of the O-ring. These motions are also motions that are performed during the demonstration to release the O-ring in the piston and successfully complete the task. Finally, the robot just moves to an initial configuration. So as a conclusion, this approach has the potential to automate industrial tasks that were not technically and or economically feasible before. Also, it reduces the time and expertise to deploy single and dual arm robot applications. Our system provides robustness and reliability against uncertainties associated with the calibration, sensor information, and variability of the positions of the work pieces. So with this approach, also we commission a task to open bottles using the dual arm manipulator. So cheers for your attention, and we will be very happy to answer all your questions and comments. So you can, for example, drop us an email in christian.vergara@kluen.be. And also I invite you to visit our website in mech.kluen.be/robotics. Cheers.